Mr. Speaker, this morning I rise with my honorable colleagues and the community at large to talk about the work to be undertaken for the establishment of a History and Legacy Committee. Mr. Speaker, many of us are walking on paths that have been tread for us by those who came before us. Our parents, grandparents, educators, political and community leaders, some of whom were groundbreakers, and most of whom were average citizens. Their effort to develop Bermuda, to develop the Bermuda that we live in today, have created opportunities for us to continue to improve Bermuda so that we can make our nation better, so that we can all thrive within our community. As we move forward with education reform, we know that change in education is not only desired, but it is a prerequisite to designing the kind of public education system that inspires confidence and meets the educational, societal, and other related needs of each and every learner. Mr. Speaker, when important things are to be gained, like better education for each and every child, it is critical to keep in mind what we do not want to lose. These changes, which are the government's response to community calls for change, have brought about long-standing issues and concerns about Bermuda's educational history and legacy to the forefront. From lived experiences, discussion with our family members, concerns for our constituents, and from prior debates in this House, we know that our country's history is a difficult and painful one, especially for those of our parents' and our grandparents' generations. It is rich with examples of our great history of buildings and trades, seafaring and shipbuilding, and developing and shaping young minds and leaders. However, it is also a painful and difficult history of racial segregation, separate and unequal schools, and class stratification. Along with my predecessors, I recognize that decisions have been made in decades past that continue to have profound implications on current and former students of the Bermuda public school system and Bermudian society. Many members know about the vital history of schools such as the Bermuda Technical Institute, Howard Academy, Warwick Sec, Prospect School for Girls, Robert Crawford, and others that have been closed or repurposed in decades past. Mr. Speaker, during the recent consultation on parish primary schools, I was reminded and reminded and reminded again about these critical issues and of the need to teach, learn, know, understand, and appreciate our educational history and legacy. In addition to listening and reading the numerous submissions from community members, I also received many messages of support and met directly with community members passionate about protecting and preserving the history and legacy of schools. Through this process, it has become evident that despite very good intentions and the imperative to bring about change for young people, a response was needed that met the moment of change that we are undertaking. Mr. Speaker, prior to making a single decision about parish primary schools, I resolved that these concerns had to be addressed. As I listened and considered the concerns, mostly of elders, with deep connections to particular schools and school communities, it was evident that while there have been significant contributions made to documenting and understanding Bermuda's educational history, more was and is needed. Therefore, I committed to establishing the History and Legacy Committee to engage with the community and to document, commemorate, and preserve Bermuda's educational and school histories and legacies. Mr. Speaker, of course, this effort could be easily misjudged as just another government committee being thrown at a problem. I can assure you and the members of this Honorable House that this is indeed not that. This past summer, I met directly with passionate and committed community members, including adult children of renowned educators, current and former educators, parents of current students, and many of whom were also public school alumni. I also met with technical officers at the Ministry of Youth, Culture, and Sports, historians and researchers, and community and cultural leaders to share feedback from the parish primary consultation to engage in deep discussions about the history and legacy of schools and education and to obtain input on the development of the History and Legacy Committee. This assistance helped shape the vision and design of the History and Legacy Committee. Mr. Speaker, subsequently, I have initiated the work of the History and Legacy Committee with the appointment of the chairperson, Ms. Heather Whalen. Ms. Whalen will steer and oversee the work of the History and Legacy Committee. She has been working with members of the Ministry of Education team towards the formal establishment of this committee. The preparation work includes creating a small short-term working group to develop the terms of reference that the eventual committee will use once it's fully established and constituted. Mr. Speaker, the working group's memberships consist of Ms. Heather Whalen, who's a retired Director of Community and Cultural Affairs. During her professional career, she spearheaded a number of international events and served as the head of delegation for CARIFESTA and was a member of the team organizing the Smithsonian Folklife Festival. She is the co-author of Bermuda's first national cultural heritage policy. Well known to members of the legislature, Ms. Whalen has co-hosted several ceremonies of the convening of the legislature and has also served as a member of the committee to commemorate the 400th anniversary of the Bermuda House of Assembly. In addition, she has previously served on several government committees and is a member of the Board of Education and the interim director of Age Concern. Ms. Whalen began her career in education, teaching history and civics at the Berkeley Institute, where she also served as head of the Social Studies Department. Ms. Alberta Dyer Tucker is retired from public service, having served in numerous roles, including Assistant Cabinet Secretary and Senior Education Officer for Early Education, among other roles. She's also one of Bermuda's inaugural policy analysts and later co-led the Cabinet Office's intern program, which helped launch the career of many young Bermudians. Immediately before her retirement, Ms. Dyer Tucker helped organize a commission of inquiry, also serving as commission clerk. She later served as clerk to the Parliamentary Joint Select Committee inquiring into the events of December 2, 2016. She also briefly worked with the commission of inquiry into historic land loss in Bermuda. She is also a former educator, having begun her career as a classroom teacher at Victor Scott Primary. Mr. Adrian Lodge has worked in the IT industry for over 20 years. He has recently completed a privacy officer and cybersecurity course with a passion for always learning and improving. Adrian is a founder of local software development company, Supertone Limited. He has led the DC Startup Weekend for entrepreneurs and has volunteered at the annual hackathon and has taught WordPress. He also designs mobile apps and games for Bermuda Island Games, a local business he started to promote Bermudian culture digitally. Adrian holds a master's degree in information technology management from the University of Liverpool. Ms. Tanisha Otley is a Ministry of Education policy analyst and will provide research and secretariat support for the working group. Having reviewed and analyzed all of the submissions from the parish primary school consultation process, she has developed a deep and broad insight into the issues raised by community members regarding the history and legacy of schools and education. She is also a public school alumna, having graduated from the Cedar Bridge Academy. She obtained an associate's degree in liberal arts from Bermuda College and a bachelor's degree in social policy from the University of Lincoln, UK. Ms. Otley is currently studying towards a master's degree in public policy and management from the University of York, UK. Dr. Theodore Francis is an assistant professor of history at the Houston Tillotson University, an historically black college and university in Austin, Texas. He teaches African-American, Caribbean, and United States history courses. His research is focused on race, resistance, and black travel in the African diaspora, particularly the Caribbean and the Americas. In 2020, Dr. Francis served as an expert witness for the Government of Bermuda's Commission of Inquiry into Historic Land Losses. He completed an extensive research report on the Tuckerstown portion of these land losses. Dr. Francis is the co-author of Prudent Rebels, Bermudians and the First Age of Revolution with Dr. Clarence Maxwell and Alexander Morris Kessler. His current book manuscript explores African American tourism to Bermuda during the island's desegregation movement. Mr. Randy Scott is a retired parliamentary registrar, having served in this leadership role for many years after working as the assistant parliamentary registrar. After teaching for a period at the Robert Crawford School, Mr. Scott also worked in the Department of Statistics for more than 20 years. He is an alumni of West End Primary School and attended Sand Secondary School having completed his high school education in the United States at Aaron Preparatory School in New York City. He attended Central State University in Wilberforce, Ohio, and graduated with a bachelor's degree in history education. Dr. Kito Swan is professor of African American and African Diaspora Studies in Indiana University, Bloomington, the author of Black Power In and the forthcoming Pacifica Black, Oceana Anti-Colonialism and the African World. His scholarship is focused on 20th century Black internationalism. In 2020, Dr. Swan served as an expert witness for the government of Bermuda's Commission of Inquiry into Historic Land Losses. He submitted a report on the St. David's U.S. Baseland section of these land grabs. He is the recipient of several awards, including fellowships from the National Endowment for Humanities, the American Council of Learned Studies, Harvard University Radcliffe Institute, the Wilson International Center for Scholars, Penn State's Humanities Institute, and the Australia University of Queensland. He is also the founder of Drinkwell, a professorial consultation agency. Ms. Rhonda Wood-Smith is a senior manager of the Tourism Regulation and Policy Unit. She previously served as a senior policy analyst in the Ministry of Economic Development and Tourism and as the acting director of telecommunications. Ms. Wood-Smith has an extensive background in education. She began her career as a mathematics teacher at the Barclay Institute, graduated to the position of year three supervisor, and culminated her career at the Barclay in 2003 as head of mathematics. Ms. Wood-Smith served as the Bermuda Education Strategic Team BEST project manager and was a member of the Hopkins Review Team led by Professor David Hopkins. She later served as the Chief Operations Officer for the Interim Executive Board of Education and the Board of Education, respectfully, and is currently a member of the Board of Governors at the Barclay Institute. Mr. Speaker, the working group's membership consists of a breadth of academic, technical, and practical knowledge and experience that is needed to plan and prepare for the work of the History and Legacy Committee. Under the direction of the History and Legacy Committee's chairperson, the group will develop the terms of reference for the History and Legacy Committee, identify types of professional and community roles and skill sets necessary for the committee, identify potential work streams and supporting organizational structures and processes for the committee project, for example, research, data collection, community engagement, communications, etc. Develop a provisional project plan outlining the milestones. Make recommendations on the likely duration of the short to midterm phases of the History and Legacy Committee. Make recommendations on the likely required time contribution of History and Legacy Committee members for the project, and complete and present the terms of reference by March 31st, 2022. This two-part process in creating a working group to support the introduction of a committee has worked well before. This approach was taken regarding the School Reorganization Committee and allowed technical and community expertise from outside the Ministry of Education to be utilized to develop the groundwork for the larger body of work to be undertaken. Mr. Speaker, following the development of the terms of reference and the completion of these other responsibilities, some or all of the members of the working group will transition into the committee itself. Therefore, other members of our community will also have opportunities to serve on the History and Legacy Committee once it is formally and fully established in early 2022. This committee will use the terms of reference as a framework to guide and carry out longer term with the ultimate responsibility of documenting Bermuda's historical educational history, and making recommendations on the best ways to preserve, honor, and commemorate the history and legacy of education in Bermuda. I want to extend thanks to the persons who've made contribution to the development of the History and Legacy Committee. The interest, passion, and dedication of those committed to the documentation and celebration of our educational history will help with the necessary changes needed to the public education system and make our understanding of past educational achievements much richer in the process. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.